In these chaotic times, people of faith look to the Bible for answers. The Bible teaches us that God gave us free choice. Therefore, He gave us 10 commandments to guide us. Exodus 20:7. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless who takes his name in vain. The basic understanding of the third commandment is not to swear falsely in God's name. Are you allowed to swear falsely if you do not say God's name? Of course not. And that is because there is another commandment. Exodus 20:16. Do not give false testimony against your neighbor. Why are there two similar commandments? This commandment speaks to the leaders. World history teaches us of many leaders who have lied and spread falsehoods to very innocent people who trusted them innately. The naive masses thought that God wanted them to do what they heard from their superiors. These charlatans transgressed this third commandment. They posed themselves as emissaries of God and encouraged idol worship, theft, and murder, all in God's name. If you are in a position of leadership or superiority, like are a teacher, a chaplain, a doctor, or a parent, be careful not to give commands. Even if you do not say, "God said so," your tone of voice does. Instead, give suggestions, true explanations, and choices when speaking to people who need your help and guidance. The fourth commandment, the Sabbath. One of the laws for the foundation of a better world is to have a day of rest every single week. Even God had to rest after He created the world. Exodus 20:11. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea, and all that is in them, but He rested on the seventh day. Therefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and made it holy. We are made in the image of God. It is not possible that we are more resilient than Him. We cannot work, work, work with no rest. The Ten Commandments are repeated in Deuteronomy, where the Bible gives another purpose for the Sabbath. Deuteronomy 3:15. Remember that you were slaves in Egypt, and that the Lord your God brought you out of there with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm. Therefore, the Lord your God has commanded you to observe the Sabbath day. When we work all week long without a full day of rest, we essentially are slaves. The purpose of Exodus was to take the Israelites out of slavery. Healthy people tend to keep going on and on. Therefore, our Father in heaven had to command us to stop. Even if we do not work for pay, housework can be endless. God wants us to have quality time to enjoy our families, friends, good food, and nature. Sabbath is a day to enjoy life and relax while our worries wait. A vacation for our bodies and souls every single week.